minutes, 165. Oliveira in yellow, Makhachev in red. Tonight's fight clock is brought to you by Timex. Shop the full collection on Timex.com. Use code UFC280 for 20% off today and tomorrow.
Expect Oliveira to go forward.
Islam with a big left hand early.
It looked like he hurt him.
Nothing we haven't seen before, though.
You know Charles will get stunned, but keep fighting. The pressure of Oliveira. Oliveira takes him to the ground here. Now, Makhachev said he would take him down here. Not many people are willing to play this game with Charles Oliveira. Islam said he is not afraid. But Dubronx, as expected, starts to throw up submissions right away.
Oliveira's already been cut open for what it's worth.
Islam really trying to make sure he gets either both arms in or out here. Nice job.
Nice elbow from Oliveira off his back.
Oliveira's ground game is so good, he immediately puts you on a defensive.
Makhachev working inside that tight closed guard of Oliveira. And it's not just the submissions, Paul, when we talk about that active guard of Charles Oliveira.
He will elbow you down there. He will elbow you. He will just keep swiveling those hips. He will threaten submissions and try to do damage from the bottom. But Islam already avoided that first triangle attempt, landed a big left hand to start things off. Makhachev, this is where he wants to be. Charles invited him down.
Yeah, he did. Oliveira put himself in a position that Makhachev said he wanted to be. But as you see there, Oliveira with the active guard. Makhachev passes the half guard. Charles is going deep half sweep here.
Trying to get up. Nice job there from Oliveira. Look for the knees of Oliveira in the clinch. Very dangerous.
Great job there by Dubronx. Getting back on his feet, using that leg lock attempt to get himself back up. Now he's got Makhachev pressed against the side of the octagon.
Right in the corner of Makhachev.
Herzog using his Brazilian Portuguese to tell Charles Oliveira that his hand off the top of the octagon and now taken down.
Nice step through there by Makhachev. That wizard kick we talked about earlier.
And we said how important that would be, right, DC? So he doesn't have to shoot low. He doesn't have to put his neck into a vulnerable place against Oliveira.
But the speed at which that happened. Earlier we saw a couple labored wizard kicks. You got to attack that if you're going to try it. Now let's see what Oliveira does, his approach, as he's on his back again.
Under 2 minutes here to go round one. Khabib shouting instructions right there to his brother Makhachev.
And you see Islam move Charles towards the corner where he can take the instructions. If Charles Oliveira stays here, it's because he wants to be here. He has so many skills off of his back to try to change the position. Islam stacking him. Got to make sure the hips are covered. You cannot allow someone as good as Dubronx to get his hips off to his side. You got to keep him square.
And pushing him up against the cage is a smart approach. Because there, he can't move as much. He's got his head pressed in there. He can feel every motion coming from those hips. He knows what's happening. He knows if he's trying to swivel for an armbar or a submission attempt at all.
And this doesn't deter Charles Oliveira. If you remember, Kevin Lee had a lot of success in round one on the ground against Dubronx. So he will make the same attacks as the fight goes on.
Strong example right there coming down the stretch of round one. Jason Herzog, you can assure, will give them plenty of time to work here in these situations.
Yeah, these guys wanted to be down here. Charles invited him down, and Islam graciously came down with him. Oh, big shots.
That's something you don't want. You don't want to just continuously be stuck under Islam Makhachev. He's too good here. His base is so strong.
Makhachev keeping that elbow on the chin of Oliveira, now tries to posture up. Charles swivels a hip. Look to land an up kick.
He's down.
Stop. Round one done.
Hey, over here.
All right, look, this is that big left hand. Nice straight left, right off the bat. Look at this. We talk a whole lot about Charles Oliveira's striking, and Islam comes out with a nice strike. Harry gets a nice takedown, ends up right in half guard.
Kind of feels like Khabib wants this one even more than his own championship wins. Investment doesn't even begin to describe it when it comes to Makhachev's career and his involvement.
Oh,
another nice stick there by Makhachev early round two.
Oliveira right back under pressure. Oliveira's corner said they want him to go. Front kick to the face. Don't allow Makhachev to get close.
Chavez trying to get his own takedown.
Look for Islam to try the inside trip to take Oliveira down. As he's in close, he will take that left leg inside to try to sweep him to his back. You know, this is something that is a little bit overlooked with Oliveira. When you're in tight, he's just jamming knees into your body. It may not look like it's doing much damage, but it really wears on his opponents as the fights go on.
But Makhachev has double underhooks here.
And he's got to try to manipulate Oliveira to take him down. Charles Oliveira, you cannot take down with singles because he's so dangerous at jumping on your neck. You got to try to trip him to knock him down.
We're about 6.5 minutes in, and DC, despite the obvious skill sets in Oliveira's history, you kind of expected a longer fight tonight.
And a harder fight for both guys because of the matchups.
Good knee to the body there a moment ago from Charles Oliveira. Now back to the center of the octagon, under 3.5 in the round.
And as the fight goes longer, Oliveira will gain confidence, but Makhachev is a good striker. I know he's not known for it, but he has tremendous stand-up skills.
Islam doing just fine on his feet, though, so far in this fight.
Yeah, but the longer he does that, the more Charles Oliveira feels good defending takedowns. And in that action there against the side of the octagon, you saw that Dubronx recognize this. Maybe this is not a fight that I want to be taking guard. Right? He's defended and stayed upright, opposed to going to his back.
Pretty good combination by Makhachev there, partially blocked by Oliveira.
Head kick for Makhachev.
Yeah, again, the guard raised for Oliveira, but still a rattle.
You could see Oliveira just slightly hesitant,
yeah,
now, knowing that Makhachev is always going to try to close that distance if he stands too long and he doesn't like what he's seeing.
Charles is just not as reckless as he normally is when he's chasing guys down.
Yeah.
I think he's just aware of the takedowns coming in his direction.
I think Oliveira would...
Ooh! Oh! Knockdown from Makhachev! Right into the
half guard. He's got to watch the arm triangle here. If Makhachev can pass the guard, he's got the arm triangle. Oh, this is
finished!
So much pressure that the moment he cleared the leg, he was able to get the submission. That's how much pressure Makhachev was able to get from that top position. Unbelievable.
So Islam Makhachev, as we have said repeatedly, would be favored to beat any lightweight in the world. And in under two rounds, he stops Charles Oliveira's winning streak at 11 and gains the lightweight throne. What a moment.
You know, unreal the way that Makhachev was able to hurt Oliveira so many times on the feet. We talked all about his wrestling, the sambo, the jiu-jitsu. but it was the strikes that led to all of this. He was able to knock Oliveira down, and then once he had him hurt and had him just questioning himself for a second, he locks up this arm triangle. And like DC talked about, as soon as he even clears the leg, look, Oliveira's already tapping. That's the squeeze and the pressure.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Jason Herzog has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 16 seconds of the second round, declaring the winner by submission due to a head and arm choke, and new undisputed UFC lightweight champion of the world, Islam Makhachev.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this.